Hi, I'm Alex Pletcher. I wanted to give a brief introduction to what you're about to watch because it's the product of two people, me being one of them. Eli Deutsch is not here right now, but I'll speak on behalf of him. We made this movie for the majority of the second half of our senior year in high school in the class Creative Connections. Because you just make art in that class, and you know what? We like movies. That's art to us. So we thought a good piece of art would be to sort of do a send-up of our high school and the people we love in our high school, giving our favorite people each bits in the movie that they all play themselves to a certain degree. But the reason I'm giving this little introduction is to preface, who knows who's going to watch this movie? Half the people I tell, nobody's going to watch it. Half the people I tell, everybody's going to watch it. So, if you are watching this, please know this is like a satire. None of this is to be taken seriously. It is just a fun way for us to remember our high school and our favorite people. Because, shout out Mrs. McClay. You are the whole reason that we were even able to make this movie. But, there are people out there who could potentially, take issue with something in the movie. Who knows what? So, I just wanted to say that right off the bat. If you're in this movie and you didn't know about it, my apologies. I think we covered our tracks pretty good with that, but say you're in the background of some shot and you're upset about that, I'm sorry. Please don't ask me to take it down, because this took a lot of effort to make. And boy, is it difficult to release this, I'm not great with technology, and anytime I try to release one of these things, it's a nightmare. Hopefully this one goes seamlessly, but it's pretty long, so it's probably going to be difficult. If you are in this, and you knew you're in it, thank you very much. I just want to thank you again for that, The people in this movie I know to varying degrees, but I love you all. Eli probably wouldn't say the same, but I hope he would. The sentiment remains the same. So, that being said, this is like a long movie. You're probably looking at that runtime right now and going, do I have time for this? The answer is yes. Absolutely. But, in the description, I'll probably have, table of contents, I suppose. It'll tell you time codes, timestamps. Yeah. So the movie will go to a certain point in the credits, and as any good Samaritan does, you'll watch the credits. But the credits for our movies are always fun because it's everybody getting their own little personal shout-out and maybe some bloopers. But then after the credits, you're probably wondering, is it like a Marvel movie? Your favorite? Is there an end credit scene? There is behind the scenes and bloopers, mostly bloopers, that you would probably also like to watch. Once again, you're going to want to watch this all. After the bloopers and the behind the scenes, there is its own second film. This movie is like 4.5 minutes long. I made this to submit to college for like scholarships and stuff. You're probably going to watch it and go, really, kid? But I did. I thought this would be a fun place to put it because it goes along with the core idea of the film of remembrance. So that one is much more just my career guys having fun. But you'll watch it if you want. You don't have to. But that's there. And then at the very end, if I edit this the way I think I'm going to, but boy, is it. It's strenuous. I spent like the past 3 days, I get home, maybe lie in the hammock a little bit, but mostly editing this. So, but at the very end, if I edit it the way I think I'm going to, there's going to be a little treat for Jaden Geyer guy and those of Mr. Cruzala's class, because it's relating to something that I hinted to while we were filming your guys' portion of the movie. That being said, editing, this is going on way longer than I wanted to. Let's just get right into the movie. Thank you. God bless. Enjoy it.
Good morning and happy Monday sashes. All Adam Smith electronics classes are canceled today due to Mr. Zahos watching too much Godzilla. We have tried to email him, but he is unresponsive. Let's try to keep him in our thoughts and prayers. Mr. Zahos, If you're listening, your wife is looking for you. For lunch today, we have gray blocks that contain all necessary nutrients according to the Michelle Obama food pyramid. The lunch ladies call it 88 cents of cost-effective regulations. We call it Yum Nums. All teen moms, please report to the gym for daily consoling.
All right, daily attendance, you know it, you love it. Peg Neely.
Here.
Lauren Gierska.
Here.
Abby Brank.
Here.
Emily Smitty.
Here.
Delon Miller.
Here.
Baggy Martin.
Here.
Gaydon Jayajipe.
Here!
Jillian Bronx.
Here.
Sam?
Here.
Oh, sorry.
My bad, Big Sam.
Yeah, okay, which one of you is supposed to be the real Sam?
I am!
So we can get started on our research.
They're all too old!
So that's when I realized I wanted to be an elementary school teacher. Not to form or mold the next generation, because let's be honest, there's like a 4-year, like 5th to 8th greatest window where you've just made it into the person that you are. High school kids are just way too stupid to retain anything from their teachers. 3 to 5 protagonists just exist about every grade and have a decent and meaningful relationship with like one or two teachers they remember. And this, the rest are just being stupid, the rest of the kids.
So you consider yourself to be able to relate more to children?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I don't like it here because every time I bring up the Sonic movie, I just get constantly ridiculed, but whenever I talk about them, it's just an ongoing conversation. Like, I love it with kids. I think over there, we've watched the Sonic movie maybe like 2 or 3 times, probably going for our 4th, and it's just, also we like Five Nights at Freddy's as well. I think I know 10 kids that know the lore pretty well.
So I am like really getting them into anime. They just think it's cartoons, but they're really pretty much don't understand a single thing about it. So I tell them to watch High School DxD.
When I see it, people should have expectation rates. I'm in many chat rooms, and the majority of them thankfully agree with me, saying 39 for women and 59 for men. Because, you know, they just become old, useless, and decrepit. But if you can't walk to the third area of the dining room, then you're kind of useless to me and a lot of others.
Interest-wise, personality does cut off around 4th grade. After that, then they just think they're like mundane and bad stuff. But these kids, they are a cultural bunch.
Brennen.
being nervous. It's just channel 84 news.
What if we mess up?
You must be talking about the bloopers.
Don't say that. Don't ever say that. They may be listening.
Come on, it's not true about any of that.
Have you seen Brent since she messed up in the Dark Side of the World report?
No, but she's probably just home.
We both know that's not true.
Okay, are you star reporters ready? I got a softball game to coach.
Yep. Only one show left. Then our sentence is over. We just have to make it through it.
Okay, okay.
Hi, I'm Liam Fritcher, and this is Abby Meehan. Welcome to Channel 84 News. Today we want to tell you about an exciting new development in our school. Following the first Black massacre dubbed Brawl in Freshman Stall by supporters of the incident security, cameras have been installed in every bathroom and around the school.
That's right. Congratulations to the back corner of the auditorium for remaining as now the last place in the school where you can go unrecorded. So remember, everyone, always be smiling because you're on air.
Other news, the boys water polo team lost 123-69 in their most recent match, dropping them to a 0-58 on the season and an all-time record of 0-526-1. On the other side of the spectrum, girls water polo improved to 1-0, winning the first game in the program's history on Friday night. That doesn't sit right with me. Anyways, outside of sports, Bird Watching Club meets today in room 30. Bird Killing Club in room 32, and Hunting the Bird Watching Club in room 31.
Don't forget about Ignite Club in the auditorium and gun polishing.
Gun Polishing Club in the auditorium. That's all for Abby and I. Thanks for joining Channel 84 this year. I'm Leah Bircher.
Stay classy, Shippensburg!
'Hey guys, we're getting started. We've got presentations today. Up first, we've got Lauren Farrell. Lauren, whenever you're ready.
Thank you. The American Revolution by Lauren Farrell. The King of England was absolutely racist. Second, pilgrims were like, stop being racist. They came over to America on the Mayflower. Thirdly, the Bryan decided to shrink back and rebuild the Death Star.
We don't have to talk about this right now. I want to talk about this right now.
I can wait until after class.
I don't want our love to be a secret.
Storm.
I hear they're going to bring back Cuddle Commander to the item shop.
No way. They never bring back old skins in the shop.
It's true. They're going to do it.
I mean, Freddy Fazbear, Japanese Yen,
a box propped
up with a stick.
Do the dance.
Something. Just start moving. We're two mices. We're two little mices. We're doing the cheese of the week report from school.
Uh-huh.
Did you want to get on us? Do you want to be interviewed? Just like up for a quick interview.
Yeah.
Okay. So. Yes. Let's. Yeah. I'm Martin the mouse. Okay.
Yeah.
So we should be in show real quick. You just want to like do that.
Yeah.
I'm Martin the Mouse, and this is the Cheese of the Week report, baby! Let's go! Okay, you're in the shot, right? You got her in the shot, right? Okay, you're good, man.
Alright, thank you.
Have a great day!
This is a microphone.
Oh.
Okay, on three, we're gonna say, cheese! Can you do that? Can you do that? Okay, so, are you rolling?
One, two, three.
Don't stop. What are you, we gotta go from the start again. we actually, no, I'm not kidding. I don't want that reshot, okay?
There's glasses.
I can't. You can go. You can actually go. Fine. Thank you.
Have a great day.
It was explosive.
explain that you're really not mad.
Yeah, I can explain that as an act.
It's not an act. It's not, I'm angry. That was, we took like 20 minutes, 30 minutes getting the costumes on, and that was our one take, and that was, it was ruined.
Why was it ruined?
Is that camera on? Is that camera actually on? Are you actually recording this right now?
Mm-hmm.
You're not on the note, we're here.
We're going in.
Please.
We need to get
him.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
He knows. Nice camera.
Thank you. Whoa.
There he is.
Bomb
get in there, get in there.
John. John. John.
Yeah. There are some that we spray paint.
Yeah.
What do you need to know my name?
Okay.
I saw if this is.
Why are we going in this beer?
Shut up! Oh my. Oh, okay. Oh, is it the question? You're a inquisitive little guy. You're really inquisitive. Quiz boy Junior! Okay, I just want to ask you two questions and then we can edit that, right? You can answer two questions, right? Like each.
Yeah.
You got two options. Only two. You got Swiss cheese. Oh, you got cheddar. What do you want? You want Swiss cheddar. You gotta tell us. You can't do that. You gotta tell us. Come on.
I'll take Swiss.
Swiss boy. You got holes in you. You got some holes in you. Cut there. I just don't want to do this. I just don't.
What is this?
What? Shut up. Oh. Okay, second question. Do you even remember what the second question was?
That was.
That's not an answer. That's not helping. You never help. Shut up.
Good.
You guys love the champ statue?
No!
Oh no! I've killed you, Sam. I didn't mean for this to happen. I just wanted the brand and licensing rights. And I've prematurely ended someone's life.
Shin.
Called me Sam.
Yeah, I guess I did.
Thanks.
I grow weary and tired of these people. 11 and a half years here. My prison sentence is almost over, yet I still feel the inability to commit to finishing it. I wake up in the morning, perpetually exhausted. It doesn't matter how well the night of rest before was, it's never rest. I commit to people I care about here and feel no drive to follow through for anyone around me. I need an escape. I need to leave.
Wow, that's some deep noise, man. Next time you empath with me, why don't you open with a joke?
John, I'm so annoyed. I had this extra credit essay for accounting degree that took me 16 hours to do last night, right? And bam, you told me I couldn't do it because I already have 100. A little bit of a warning would have been nice.
Yeah.
You sound like you don't even care. You're faking like you always are. I'm leaving.
Wait, Janelle, I do care. I need the chromosome.
No, I need it. We made things bad with Janelle.
Listen. See, you made things bad with Janelle. I don't care, really. I need that chromosome so I can go back in time and send you to the Phantom Zone.
What? I thought you said you left the Phantom Zone.
I lied. This chromosome just means a lot to me. You don't really mean...
I love you.
But I will now send you back to the Venom Zone.
Oh, there you are.
I don't want to talk to you right now.
Danelle, I'm sorry. I wasn't in my feels.
Okay.
Have a great day. Whenever you're ready, I'm ready.
Don't forget about Ignite in the auditorium and gunfire. Oh, sorry, I don't mean gunfire.
Dance again? I need you for the credits dancing. Good.
Headshots.
It's a water gun. You're good. There she is. Perfect. Don't scream then. Don't scream. I'm not making you do anything you don't want, so.
All teen moms, please report to the gym for daily consulting. Leah Richer, please report to Mr. Conketical for electric bass jam session. You
You're gonna stand right there, Khalil.
That's it?
Hold this in your hand. That's what you're doing. Alright,
are you ready?
You're fine.
Make sure you speak loudly.
Oh, if I said you wouldn't have seen my face, I would have been like, quiet.
Yeah, try this on the side. I think people should have expiration dates. Yeah, we're gonna cut this from here, or you want me to continue?
We got the whole hallway in shot. You too.
You want me to walk to the end?
Sure.
You sound like you don't even care. You're faking like you always do. I'm leaving. I'll take one down here.
Wait, Janelle, I do care. Please.
Perfect, just like that.
You sound like you don't even care. You're faking like you always do. I'm leaving.
Do I put my head down or?
Say it annoyed. Real annoyed.
You sound like you don't even care. You're faking like you always are. I'm leaving.
It's fun. It's summer.
No, Janelle, please, come back.
Okay, we gotta do this now. We gotta do. Alright. No, I'm not ready. I love you. But I
wanna send you back
to the
friend zone. Oh. Is that camera on? Is that
yeah.
Camera on? Is that camera recording me?
Oh, I didn't.
Yep. Only one show. Hi, I'm Leah Britcher, and this is Abby Meehan. Welcome to Channel 74 News. Hi, I'm Leah Britcher, and this is Abby Meehan. Welcome to Channel 84 News. Today, we want to tell you about an exciting new development in our school. Following the first block massacre and dubbed brawl in freshman stall by supporters of the incident security. In other news, the boys' water polo team lost. That's supposed to be action. I'm sorry. I'm...
Action.
Here.
Baby one.
Here.
Okay.
Here.
Here.
What? Okay. Here. Bye, Willie.
Oh. You gotta say their names.
You want me to say?
Yeah, say their names
I'll
first.
Open, okay.
You can go, I'm just rolling.
Okay. Sam?
Here. Here.
Saying sorry.
Alright, which one of you is the real Sam?
I am.
I
am. Oh.
So, which one of you is the real Sam?
I am!
Nice sunglasses, idiot. Whoa. Now. Nice sunglasses, idiot.
What?
Whoa.
No.
They're done.
All right, well, stay safe. All right, hold on, hold on. You gotta get back.
No, this is good because you're like a guy. This is like, yeah.
Ready? Okay. All right, so I'm gonna start on you guys. Then I'll pan to you, Pika. You gotta get behind Kylie. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm in the very.
I gotta get the gun away.
All right, action.
I started laughing.
Look at this guy, he's bringing his Art Honor Society juice. What type of juice is that, young man?
My blood.
Sweet! So I'm making that. Sam with his hat. And then it cuts to perfection, the crab hat.
Am I supposed to be scared?
Yeah. Do the dance!
Hang on, hang on. I don't even know what that means.
I don't know.
He said a lot of words. There's a crowd coming behind me. Drop my heart.
Wait, should I like get up a little bit?
Yeah, you can sit up. Like, yeah, you can just lean forward.
Oh no. I've killed you, Sam. I didn't mean for this to happen. I just wanted the brand and license and Lysol.
Yeah, you pretend you're dead. Multiple takes.
I'll be right back. I'm just gonna go get some juice.
Your bells are out of control.
Shut them out the door. Okay. Are you ready? Are you done? Okay. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get some juice.
Why is it so firm?
Like, you're talking to a fun little kiddo. Yeah. He's playing basketball.
Okay. I'll be right back. I'm gonna get...
That was good. I like that.
Oh. Oh, man.
I didn't consent for him to be in it.
I don't care. Hey.
Did you
to get it closer. Something like that, yeah, like mid-waist. Head's right there.
Sure.
We need more bodies. Okay, then we just did.
I think it's more important. Go on the other side of it. I think it'd be more interesting to get you walking away from it.
Oh, like
walking with the camera.
With this?
Yeah.
It's not smooth though. The camera's no shake.
It has shake. The ground's not completely smooth.
It's something,
all right?
It's something.
Yeah. We gotta give 100% of effort, like 100% of the time in here, I guess, because if we give any bit of a little bit of a... Well, it's not like we're shooting it today. She just, like, accuses you of being lazy.
Oh, yeah. This is gonna make us hate each other.
I'm not hating you right now.
No, but I'm hating him.
Hi, welcome back. I just wanted to say a brief thank you. This is a little interruption. I'm not going to take your time for too long. I didn't feel like setting the tripod up, so I'm just sitting here. Mrs. McClain wanted me to make it clear, a little clearer, that the point of this movie... You know what? I didn't even go back and watch the original video. Maybe the point was clear there. The point of this movie was just, you know, to have fun and remember people. And you know what, I think I did make that pretty clear in the first video, so I'm not going to be too redundant. But, I just want to thank everybody again. You know, if I In this final year of school, the past like 2 years, we had COVID. But in this final senior year, we actually went into school. And I made a lot closer friendships to people that, you know, maybe I didn't know too well before. And this movie, you know, I got to put those people in this movie. You have people like Little Sam, who, you know, I know Little Sam, but now I go mini golf with Little Sam. I'm friends with Little Sam. Little Sam's one of the funniest people I know. Andrew Pika, Angela Kai. Those are younger kids. I did not know you guys, straight up. And now, you know, you're our future. You know, the school's in good hands. Or someone like Leah, you know. Leah, you became, like, the bright spot in school for me. I can't stand school, but going to school, knowing you'd be there, and I'd have the chance to make you smile or just talk to you, made me extremely happy. I know you may not be able to say the same about me, but you definitely made me happy. So I'm glad that I got to put these people in the movie, and everybody, you know, everybody, thank you so much for being in the movie. And I have to say, I'm sorry if I spelled your name wrong in the credits. Lauren Karaskowski, number one. If I spelled your name wrong, and this goes to anybody, it's not out of a lack of caring. It's out of a lack of either not, I guess not caring. I didn't feel like looking it up. Or I couldn't figure it out. Like, Lauren, I couldn't find anywhere to, like, confirm how to spell your name. So, if I spelled your name wrong, I'm sorry. But, that said, thank you all again so much. Everyone who was involved, everyone who watched it, thank you.
William, why are you excited to stay in Shippensburg?
Because I want to become a supply chain manager, and Shippensburg University has a very good business program for that. I also love the town because of, you know, all the community. There's a lot of community stuff you can do. You can go to the Memorial Park if you want to have fun in the summer. You can go to Sheets if you want to grab a quick drink, or you just, it's a lot of fun.
One of the reasons why I'm excited to stay in Shippensburg for my college endeavors is because of all the friends I've made that will be staying here. I've grown attached to this town because of how long I've been here. I've grown up here. And, you know, I don't think I'm quite ready to let it go yet. All the places like Goose Brothers, which is an amazing ice cream shop, Red Rooster, which is a pizza shop in Cleversburg, is amazing. I love it. And then just all the memories I've made at Memorial Park and Tiger Stadium, they're just also amazing, and I don't feel like I can leave that yet.
What do you love about Shippensburg, Jonathan?
To be honest, I love the people that live in Shippensburg, including my friends and everybody that I know.
What are your plans after high school, Logan?
I plan to enlist as a combat medic in the Army because I'm looking to get out of my hometown and see different places in the world, go all over the different countries, out of state, everywhere I can go.
I'm excited to go to Oklahoma, get ready for basic, actually complete basic, and see what the surrounding area is like. And then eventually, can't wait to re-meet with the friends and family and come back after military life.
I'm gonna start times hanging out, making movies with you guys, doing stunts that we shouldn't be doing, come up with fun new ways to hurt each other. I'm glad you and Eli are gonna keep doing stuff, making movies, stuff that you love to do, and I can't wait to see what you guys come up with in the future, and someday maybe I'll be able to watch it.
Khalil, what will you miss about Shippensburg?
Well, since I'm going to Maryland, I'll be like 2 hours away, if I were to miss something from Shippensburg, it would most likely be the people I met here. You know, my friends, the colleagues I made from work, they're wonderful people. But I'm sure when I'm going to Maryland, I'll probably stop by a couple of times to make sure if they're doing okay.
Why are you excited to leave Shippensburg?
Yeah, bro. You ever feel like you're born, like, in the wrong area?
I
I love the people in Ship. I have a lot of fond memories in Shippensburg. But I'm more than excited to like seek out this other like part of me that I, you know, just can't develop here. You know, I'm going to out of town to a really nice college, you know. I'm happy.
You good to go?
I don't remember this. I want to see this.
Okay, I'll show it to you. Well, it's in the movie. You'll see it.
Okay. When's it coming out?
I don't know. Probably Friday. Hopefully.
Oh, really?
I'm hoping.
Through the line! Through the line!
Getting a character. Go.
Can I say that, but like now that I have you centered?
Eli, sit down or I'm going to choke you out.
Paying for your dinner, so I need to take you out to dinner sometime.
Alex, I think you need to get on anxiety meds. They are life changing.
I don't believe in medication.
I didn't either, but Alex, I would have never been able to do that movie if I wasn't on medication.
Well, you did great. Not as good as Leah, but you did really good.
Oh, please. Eli, get your.
We're gonna put this in the movie. Who knows? There's the baby that Jane ran over. Baby Jane ran over is in relation to the opening line of the movie done by the wonderful Mr. Bryan Smith, the teen pregnancy line. Who knows if that'll remain in the movie? I talked to Leah today and told her that's completely up to her if she wants the alternate line about her jamming out with Mr. K, because you should see her in that electric bass at the jazz concert, or the pregnancy line. I think the pregnancy line's funny. I think Eli wrote that one. That was a funny line, Eli. Because originally, I studied the human condition with JGG, which is right here, which is also the title of their own short film, was supposed to be the ending of this movie. Kind of tied all together. But then Eli said that he wanted everything to be shot in the school in the movie, and you know what? It's a pretty good idea, because that's kind of the whole point of what we did. Because originally, the Logan Cabretti bit, where he plays Stallone's character from Cobra, and blows Eli's head out with a water gun, was supposed to be in Walmart. And Angelina Licata, who no longer works at Walmart, God bless her, was supposed to wipe up his brains in like the hall. We were going to film that at like 4 a.m., because it was going to stop us at Walmart. But, you know, he said, no, I don't want to do that at Walmart. I want everything to be done at school. So we changed the ending of the movie to the John and Janelle Gone with the Wind kiss. Is that not just the greatest thing you've ever seen? Once again, I don't even know if I'm putting this in the movie. Look at that. How cute's that? You know? You may not have even noticed that. That took me like 15 minutes. No. That's a gross exaggeration. That took me like 6 minutes to cut all those out. Here's Unified Bocce second season. I don't know if this is coming into the camera well. Who knows if I'm even in focus. I did that in the newspaper, as well as doing the student spotlight. Daniel Hoon, Tristan Bidell, Declan Berker, and of course, Leah Britcher, our student spotlights. Let's head over to this magazine. Them Kids is Outrageous. Thank you, Mr. Peters, for understanding us and just, you know, not making us edit this at all and letting us, yeah, I typed that in as a way of spiting William, like, hey, bro, do a little bit of this, you know? If you're not even going to look at what I write down, then I'm just going to turn it in as is and see what Mr. Peters says. He didn't. Mr. Peters loved it. He read it in front of the whole class and said, oh, boy, this is great. So Them Kids is Outrageous stayed in, and, you know, what more could you want? A touching tribute highlights Evening of Jazz, written by me alone. Them Jazz Kids touched me. I had to give them an article. I had to write that one out of my way. I thought the Evening of Jazz was the jazziest thing I've ever heard in my life, stated Lauren Farrell. I couldn't have said it better myself. Now, one more thing.
The student spotlight.
I did it too. Sabrina Wiley, Arian Goncar, Kaylee Miller, and Logan Hutchins. Look at that. I painted that. Let's see how close to the lens I can get. I painted that. Leah and her birds hung in the library for a little bit because I'm talented. We asked these kids Will Smith or Chris Rock in the grand tradition of Mr. Peters letting us do what we want. Kaylee said or. Do you know the level of intelligence that takes to have such a clever response? I mean, that shook me to my core. That was one of the best things I've ever heard in my life. Or. Will Smith or Chris Rock. Or. Brilliant. Absolutely great. I can probably edit this a little bit out. Me trying to figure out how to shut this thing. Oh. Rascal. This was our trip with the Future Business Leaders of America, I think it was. What were we doing on that trip? Who knows, but whenever you're in journalism, you get the inside scoop on literally everything, and it's a way to get out of school. Plus, I love baseball, so Eli, William, and I went. Rascal signed the Harrisburg Senators hat. They lost to the Hartford Yard Goats. What a day that was. If you're still watching this, I didn't even put this in the table of contents, so thank you. And I love you, you're a real one.